Hi students, I am Shivaraj Rajendran from Minds of Aspirants, and a brief introduction about me is that I have been associated with civil services exam for the past 10 to 12 years, and I have given like 9 attempts I have given, and in that 9 attempts I have continuously written 8 mains. That 8 mains, 6 interviews I have gone. And of course, it was with anthropology that was I was able to go for 4 interviews. But yes, other subjects and other options like geography, psychology, public administration. I have also written mains using these options, but anthropology happened to be the one which helped me score a better result. But also the interest that I gained out of this subject was much better, much larger, maybe larger than the other subjects. So I thought I would make an answer discussion video with the question paper which had come last night, which many felt that it was a little unconventional. That is why the purpose of making this video is that I want to show you that it is not unconventional, or it is not that unconventional. Rather, if you are very if you are serious about this subject and you have a little bit of interest in this subject, you would have been able to gain far better marks than any other person. So I think as we discuss this subject, you will definitely understand that this was not an unconventional subject. Rather, it was a very interesting subject. So shall we start? So we'll start. So this was the unconventional paper which everyone was talking about. But I would show you with the answers that this was very nice question paper in terms of content that I meant. So first we'll discuss each question, but we'll first go to this 1A, which is Natufian culture, which really is most interesting because everyone in syllabus you have words like Paleolithic, Mesolithic, Neolithic, everything is there, but we actually overlook the conceptual clarity in those words. What is Paleolithic? What is Mesolithic? What is Neolithic? We don't imbibe the things which are necessary. If you had imbibed the necessary ingredient, you would have seen that this Natufian culture. So this Natufian culture is nothing but the culture which is prevalent, or which is the start of Mesolithic. At the start of Mesolithic, or at the start of agriculture, that is, agriculture has not started completely, which is the phase where Neolithic goes, or it agriculture or hunting gathering has slightly reduced because of change in climate. So it is the transition period. If you see, you will know that it is the transition between the Paleolithic and Neolithic. So you can group it in Mesolithic. So you can very well write the characteristic features which you have read for Mesolithic for Natufian culture. But specifically, what is Natufian culture, we will discuss. But a broad idea of where this stands is what I had given. So this Mesolithic Natufian culture, if you see, I'll show you in the map where it is. So if you closely watch, this area which is called as the Natufian culture happens to be in reference for every book. For example, everyone would have known a book called as Sapiens. by Yuval Noah Harari. So, are guns, germs, and steels? Guns, germs, and steels. It's a very nice book. So, if you see this reference, all these will actually start R. Okay, R. In our Emperor and Ember, that is the book which is suggested, this Natufian culture is very clearly given with a big caption. So you will find all these things or all these important or these topics in every book possible. But it is up to us to see where it lies and imbibe the essence of that subject. So what it Natufian means is basically, if you see, so in this zone, which is the most controversial, for example, the most controversial, if you ask me today, it is not West Asia, or the Islamic countries which are there. It is not the most controversial. Rather, if you see, this area, which is the most controversial between Jerusalem and Palestine, this is the most controversial region of this world, and this region is what you will if you had gone back 10,000 years ago. So 10,000 years ago, if you had gone back to the same spot, it is not called as Jerusalem or Palestine. It was called as something called as Natufian. So the place where Jerusalem and Israel is present now, that place is what is called as Natufian or Natufian culture. Why it has prominence means this guns, germs, and steels book, if you read it, has one specific character. Why this area was the start in the 10,000 BC for an agricultural development means guns, germs, and steel. There is a thing like, for example, if you see this, there is a mountain here. The mountain here is called as Zagros Mountain. Zagros Mountain. Okay. This mountain and a nearby place is also there. It is called as Kettelhau. This is what scientists say is the advent of agriculture or the start of agriculture. You can see the start the weather or the seeds of agriculture starting in this Kettelhau or near this Zagros Mountain or near this Natufian culture, or you can even call it as Levant. So whatever name you want, you can call. But this is the region everything started. But you can ask me the reason why it started in that place. So for that, this book called as Guns, Germs, and Steel gives a wonderful explanation saying that, for example, the whole thing, be it rice, wheat, barley, whatever you eat, all rice, wheat, barley, whatever you eat, all belong to a family called as grasses. Actually, all are grasses. So we are eating these grasses. But if you see that, when scientists go back and see in this region, this Natufian region, or this Kettelhau, or this Zagros Mountain, this whole area is where the wild varieties. So these wild varieties of all these grasses you will find in that region. So what this guns, germs, and steel says is that why that area was chosen specifically, because that area was the area which contained all these grasses in wild variety. When you have that wild variety or the abundance of wild variety, you have the environment which is aiding you through two rivers, which is, you will know that it is Euphrates and Tigris. There is two rivers or adjoining or in the adjoining area. You would find that civilization Mesopotamia later develops. How it develops? It develops from this Natufian culture only. This is the logic. Mesopotamia did not come in one day. But the logic is that from this Natufian culture, diffusion, as we saw classical evolution, next is diffusion. So in diffusion, if you see, we talk about cultural diffusion. But what is that cultural diffusion? This is what is called as cultural diffusion. That is diffusion of ideas for agriculture, transforming from monoculture, that is Natufian, to Mesopotamia. But here we are asked to address only Natufian. So we'll stick to that Natufian culture. So this, if you see, this is the background of Natufian culture. And but the next, how to write answer. So that is the most important. So whatever we discussed, that is the one part. But the next part, how to write answer. That is what I, if whatever you read, it is very important to translate into paper. That is most important, because marks are very important. So it is a 10 mark question. So 10 mark question. So it is a 10 mark question. So what you have to do is you have to have two papers, right? Two papers you have to write. In this only, you should know that what content you have to write. In this, what content means, first Natufian, as I said, Natufian culture. Natufian. So, you should immediately say that it is a culture which was developed in the time of 10,000 BC, where there was a transition from a hunting-gathering society to a agricultural society, or a little pre-agricultural society. So this is what is Natufian. Next thing you have to write, this is point one. The next point you have to write, definitely draw geography or location, geographical location. So you have to draw a small diagram. You have to draw here small diagram. Definitely it is very important. So when you draw, mark this place as Levant or Natufian or whatever name, or you can say the recent Israel Palestine. You add that. That also is very looks good. The recent Israel, countries of Israel and Palestine. So when you add that, that will give you a wonderful edge over other students. So when you draw, it will look good. Third is when you start explaining the characteristic features. Now, what to write, you wonder what to write. And what to write, you write the features. You don't have to know what was in Natufian everything. You just write what was in Mesolithic. Mesolithic, if you see, it is a small pre-agricultural society. Or it is a, that is why, because earlier in the Paleolithic period, the ice age was there. Now slowly the transition is taking place to a Neolithic stage, where warming of the earth is happening, but it is in a pre-agricultural stage, or it is in a transition stage. So you should write it is a pre-agricultural. Pre-agri. That is completely it has not started, but it is starting. So pre-agri. Fourth. When you have pre-agri, immediately think in Mesolithic, what is in pre-agri? If it is pre-agri, means you are starting to save, what is that? Seeds, surplus you are starting. So when there is a surplus, immediately some pottery will be there. But see, pottery in Neolithic, it is actually shining, or it is made with wheels and colorful things, but it is not the way here in Natufian. In Mesolithic also, you can understand pottery in ground, slow, or you should say a slow arisal of something called as pottery. How in this area pottery is there? Because they have they dig the ground and they save, because when you start agriculture, your surplus starts. When surplus starts, you have to save them. So obviously, you start building some pit where you are going to store the grains which you are taking for the future, and as well as for supplying family. So pottery will be there. Then next, fifth point, tool change will be there. Tools will change. So earlier, what are the tools? Crude tools or stone tools in Solterian, Magdalenian, you would have seen in that is Upper Paleolithic period. These tools are for hunting. So these tools were for hunting. So from hunting, a paradigm shift. Hunting, now sickles are for agriculture the tools are starting to come. So you are telling, you are talking about tools. So sixth, earlier they were moving in bands. Now permanent settlement, So seventh, so when the permanent settlement start, the culture starts developing, right? Culture starts developing. When culture starts developing, you start having a habit of burial. So in Kettlehawk, actually, if you see in the Natufian culture, the next to it is, I said Kettlehawk. Kettlehawk, they actually buried their dead people inside their house itself. So when permanent settlement starts, you start having this connection to your buried ancestors. So start of buried ancestral worship starts. Earlier hunting gathering, they were moving here and there, and hence more importance was given to nature, rivers, stone tools or trees, something like that. But now permanent settlement is starting, so slowly burial is happening. Sorry, in the sense that the burials are being respected and ancestor worship is starting to blossom here. And eighth, you write the conclusion or whatever you want, in the sense that this gave rise to, as I showed you, this gave rise to the next important significant civilization, which is called as Mesopotamia. So what they have given rise to is Mesopotamia and culture of world. You can just conclude. And with this, if you see, you will have a holistic answer. You should not speak only, for example, Natufian means Natufian. You have to diversify your points. So Natufian, what is Natufian? What is the, you can write the year there in Natufian introduction, then the geographical distribution, then you should say mainly pre-agricultural or starting of agriculture. Explain the answers which I gave or the reasons which I gave, you can include in that. But when you have agriculture, you start having a pottery or crude pottery, not the completed pottery, crude pottery in ground for storing. Next, when you are changing to this economy, you have to obviously change the technology which you are using from a hunting gathering to sickle agriculture. Then immediately when you start doing that, you have to have a permanent settlement for agriculture, because land will be very close. When you have a permanent settlement, you start having culture. Culture primarily starts here from burial of dead ancestors. And conclusion, you just conclude what you want. As you feel is the correct answer. And I feel this way forward that is giving rise to Mesopotamia will look very good. And this is the first question.